We will begin with a brief history on how the Black History Month began. May I have your attention, please? I'm still here talking. Thank you. In 1926, Carter G. Woodson founded the National Negro Week, which was typically held on the second week of February in honor of Frederick Douglass' birthday on February 14th, which is today, and Abraham Lincoln's birthday on February 12th. Woodson created this week-long celebration because he felt that Black people were underrepresented in the books and conversations that shaped the study of American history. His hope was that Black history would be incorporated into the teaching of American history. Woodson believed that if a race has no history, it has no worthwhile tradition, it becomes an integral factor in the thought of the world, and it stands in danger of being exterminated. Though the acknowledgement of Black History Month 50 years later was a great feat, Woodson's vision was that a week or month-long celebration would no longer be needed in years to come. During the Civil Rights era and the heightened awareness of Black culture, National Negro Week evolved into Black History Month on college campuses. In 1976, President Giroux officially acknowledged Black History Month in the U.S. In his speech, he proclaimed that in celebrating Black History Month, we can take satisfaction from this recent progress in the realization of the ideals envisioned by our founding fathers, but even more than this, we can seize the opportunity to honor the too often neglected accomplishments of Black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout our history. Though Woodson's vision has not yet been realized in all curricula across the country, significant strides have been made in education since the national recognition of Black History Month. Through our program today, we hope to whet your appetite just a little with regard to some of the contributions Black Americans have made in music.
Thank you. The gumbo dance is an African dance that's performed by dancers wearing lute. The sound of the echo or a different calling to say something to another person may show this ritual. This was used to communicate in the minds that they were strictly not talking, otherwise there would be severe threat and punishment at the end of this career.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Negro spirituals, gospel, blues, jazz, rhythm and blues. And now, for our next performance, it is the first ever recorded commercial hip-hop song. This song was originally over 4 minutes long, but is often shortened to approximately 4 or 6 minutes. Welcome to the stage some of our staff members who will perform a short version of Rapper.
Was unrecognized. I want you to take the time, a few moments, to look at the pictures and read the historical information in the Black History display right outside in the main lobby. I think you'll find it very interesting if you take the time to read about the first Memorial Day. I think many of you will be surprised, and I'm talking about students and educators, the information that happens to be on that. At this point, I would like for you to do something that you already probably most of you have out. I'd like you to pull out your cell phone.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Everybody take out your cell phone. If you don't have a cell phone, a piece of paper and a pencil is fine.
What's up, guys?
I'm going to ask you to type a few words in. And then I want you to think about those words. Don't erase it right away. Take a few days to look at it. Are we ready? Okay. There are two words, no and no. There's K-N-O-W, which is knowledge of something. And know that means nothing. So this is how we're going to begin. Type in K-N-O-W, space. H-I-S-T-O-R-Y, no history. Next line. K-N-O-W, space. Y-O-U. Drop down two spaces. Type in the word N-O. Next word, H-I-S-T-O-R-Y. No history. Last line, N-O-Y-O-U. No history, know yourself. Without history, you don't know who you really are.